Good evening, everyone. It's Chandrakala here. Today we will see the last portion of the 8th chapter, that is about energy and power. So this topic actually we have already covered in the 2nd chapter. So you can take it just as revision of those particular things. So here the first thing is conservation law of energy. That means we know that conservation law of energy states that the total energy of universe always remains constant. It can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can be only transformed from one form to another. Here we will make the use of the fact that it can be transformed from one form to another. Some transformation examples are given here. These all examples we have already studied in 2nd chapter. So the first example given is heating devices. That means your electric heater, electric iron. In all these things, electrical energy is converted into heat energy. This is your first example. And the second example is electric lamp or bulb. We know that it converts electrical energy into heat and light. Then the third example is electric motor. We know that electric motor converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. This we have studied in detail in 2nd chapter. And the next one is electrolyte, or you can say accumulator. Here one particular accumulator is given, that is the lead accumulator. Accumulator means actually those devices which stores energy. They are known as accumulator. So that means your capacitors, your cell, battery, electrolytic cell, all these. So they store the energy in the form of chemical energy. Okay, that means the electrical energy can be stored in the form of chemical energy, and when the cell will be used, then the same chemical energy will be converted into electrical energy back and our device will be able to work. Okay, next one is given, microphone. About microphone, we have already discussed in detail. Microphone means actually your mic which you are using on stage. That is known as microphone. Actually, we produce sound energy. That means when we produce sound with the help of vocal cords, that is the sound energy. So this microphone, sorry, it's microphone, not microwave. So this microphone or microwave converts those sound energies, sound into electrical signals. That means it converts sound energy into electrical energy. Then those sound are transferred up to loudspeaker in the form of electric signals. Then the loudspeaker converts them back into sound energy along with some amplification. So basically microphone or mic converts sound energy into electrical signals. And here along with that, the loudspeaker is also given. In loudspeaker, electric energy is converted into sound energy again along with some amplification. And the last example given is electromagnet. We know that in an electromagnet, the electric energy is converted into magnetic energy. This we have already seen in class 9th and we have studied about it in detail. These are some energy conversions. Now we will learn some formulas, how we will calculate the amount of electrical energy consumed. That means when we are paying an electric bill, it becomes necessary that first of all we have to calculate how much electricity has been consumed in a particular house. Accordingly only we can pay the payment. So that means we have to learn some formulas to calculate the amount of electrical energy. We have studied that the potential difference is work done per unit charge. And we know that this same work done is actually energy. This we have seen in detail in 2nd chapter, work done and energy. In this case, it will be same. Both will have same unit as joule. So from here, if we will calculate work done, that will be our energy only. And to calculate this work done, it will be V into Q. That means this is voltage and this is the amount of charge consumed by that particular appliance or by the all the appliances which were used in the home, how much charge was consumed and at what voltage it was consumed, that will give us the amount of electrical energy consumed in that particular house. Okay, now we know that current I is charge per unit time, or you can say rate of charge. In that case, Q will be equal to IT. So if instead of this Q we will put this IT, then this work done or energy will be equal to VIT. This is one more formula to calculate the work done. Now here, according to the things given in the question, you can change them. For example, if V is not given, then you use V is equal to IR. Put the value of V as IR. So from here, W is equal to, instead of V, we will put I R. This IT already here, that means it is equal to I square RT. That means it's possible that if in any numerical question the value of voltage is not given, but the value of current and resistance is given, so you can use this. And similarly, instead of this I, you can use from here I is equal to V upon R. Therefore, W is equal to, instead of this I square, we can write down V square upon R square into R into T. 1 R will cancel out, and the formula will be V square T upon R. This is one more formula to calculate the amount of work done, or in other words, we can say that the amount of electricity consumed in a house. So basically, these are some formulas to calculate the amount of energy consumed. Now we will see the power consumed in a particular house, or we can say power consumed by a particular appliance. These are some formulas which we have learned for work done. That means, in other words, we can say that the amount of energy consumed by a particular appliance or more than appliance. This is formula for energy consumed. And if you want to find out power, then we know that power is equal to work done upon time. That means if we will divide all these formulas by time, then we will get power, because all these are formulas for work done, and work done per unit time is known as power. So if you want to calculate power, we will divide all these values by T. Divided by T, VQ upon T, I square R upon T, RT upon T, V square T upon R into T. Now you see, from here you will get this, from here you will get this, and from here you will get this. That means power is equal to VI is equal to V into Q upon T is equal to I square R is equal to V square upon R. These are the formulas for calculating power. Actually, if we will learn formulas for work done, then no need of learning formulas for power separately, because we will divide those formulas by time and we will get the value of power in this case. About power, we have already discussed, and the SI unit of work done is joule, that we know, and the SI unit of power, if this is joule and this is second, because we are talking about SI unit. So SI unit of power, if you want to write down for work done, you can write for work done it is joule, and SI unit of power is equal to work done upon time, that means joule per second, and this joule per second is also known as watt. So watt is the SI unit of power. Now if you want to calculate the power in higher units, because the amount of power consumed will be very high, so we cannot use such a small unit. So in that case, we can use mega, giga, as we need, right? And basically kilo and watt. That means kilowatt and watt. These are the basic units used for power. Okay, now our question is, we want to calculate the amount of electricity consumed in the house, right? From here, you know that power is equal to electricity consumed upon time, or you can say work done upon time. So that means you can say that electricity consumed or work done is equal to power into T. That means work done can also have unit as watt into second, right? This is also SI unit, because watt is the SI unit of power, and this is the second is the SI unit of time. That means if you see in question, the unit is given in the form of power into time. That means we are talking about energy consumed or the amount of work done. So, if one unit is given as watt hour, now you see, watt is the unit of power and hour is the unit of time. It's not SI unit, but still it is the unit of time. That means we can say that this watt hour is the unit of energy consumed, because this is actually a unit which represents power into time. Power into time. Therefore, it's representing energy consumed, electrical energy consumed, or the amount of work done by the appliance. So we can use one of the unit of electrical energy consumed as watt hour. Definition we have already learned in second chapter, still we will revise is it if a device of or if an appliance of power of 1 watt, 1 watt works for 1 hour. This is our 1 hour. Then the energy consumed by appliance will be 1 watt hour. That means if you want to define 1 watt hour, that means in an appliance of power 1 watt, if it works for 1 hour, then how much electricity it consumes, that energy is known as 1 watt hour. Now we have to see its relation with SI unit. This is very important topic. 1 watt hour is equal to 3600 joule. This we may need, actually we will need in numerical questions. But one more unit we have which is more important than this, that is kilowatt hour. Now you see, watt is the unit of power and kilowatt is also unit of power. Kilowatt is a bigger unit than watt. Therefore, this is power, this is time. That means again we are talking about energy consumed. Power into time, energy consumed. That means if you want to define 1 kilowatt, that means if an appliance of power 1 kilowatt works for 1 hour, works for 1 hour, then same thing, energy consumed will be equal to 1 kilowatt hour, right? If an appliance of power 1 kilowatt is working continuously for 1 hour, then how much energy it will consume? That energy will be equal to 1 kilowatt hour. Again, we have to remember the relation between 1 kilowatt and joule, that is 3.6 into 10 raised to power 6 joule. Okay, both these relations we have to remember clearly so that we can solve numericals. Okay, now the next topic is power rating. Power rating means when we purchase any electrical appliance, its power is written on it. Along with its power, voltage is also written. That means, suppose if you will take any particular thing, it can be written on that 50 volt and 220 volt, because basically here in India, the voltage is supplied at 220 volt only. That's why we are just taking the example as 220. But in numericals, you can get 230, 250, whatever. As they will give, accordingly, we will solve our numerical. So, if it is written on that particular appliance that 50 volt and 220 volt, that means that device consumes a power of 50 volt. And we know that volt means joule per second. That means your device is using 50 joule of energy in 1 second. Per second, that particular device will use 50 joule of energy when it is connected to a voltage of 220, right? Because as soon as you will change this voltage, this power will also change. That means obviously, if the appliance will not get sufficient amount of voltage, if it has to work on 220 but you are not giving 220, then it will get less power. That means it won't be able to consume 50 volt, it will consume less than that. And if you are giving more voltage, then it can take more voltage also. But this situation states that if you are giving a voltage of 220 volt, then your device will consume 50 joule of energy in 1 second. So this information which is written on the appliance, it help us to calculate two things. First one, resistance, and second one, current. Here current means we are talking about safe limit of current. Safe limit of current or safe current. That means if you will exceed a voltage or current more than this, then your appliance can get damaged, it can burn. So that is the safe limit for which we use fuse, electric fuse. So we have learned right now that power is equal to VI and power is equal to V square upon R. So you see from both these formulas, if you have power and voltage, this is power, this is voltage. If you have power and voltage, you can calculate I. And this I will be safe current. That means if the current will exceed beyond this limit, your appliance can get damaged. Similarly, if you have power and voltage, you can calculate resistance also. That means from here we can calculate two things, that is the power and the resistance. Our next topic is household consumption of electrical energy. That means in home we are using a lot of devices. So on what basis actually we pay the payment to the electricity board? That means how much electricity we have consumed. We will calculate first of all that, and then the electricity board will decide that how much we have to pay for 1 kilowatt hour. So if they are saying that you have to pay 5 rupees for 1 kilowatt hour, then we will calculate total energy, how much we have consumed, and then we will multiply that energy by 5. We will get the total electricity bill. So if we have to calculate this, then we have already discussed that the electricity bill which we pay at our home, that is measured in kilowatt hour. So that must be measured in kilowatt hour. And kilowatt hour means, you know, that this is power and this is time. That means how much power you have used that in kilowatt hour and for how many hours. That means for if for 1 hour, then 1, then 2, then 2 hours. Okay. And if, but most of the time on a particular device, the power is written in watt. That means it's not in kilowatt. So if the power is given in watt, if you want power in watt, then you divide it by 1000. Because to convert this kilowatt into watt, you have to divide it by 1000. Right? So you do one thing, multiply it by 1000 and divide it by 1000. So your this multiplied thing will be balanced by this kilowatt and watt, and this divided by 1000 will be with you. Right? So that means if you are using your power in watt, then you have to divide the equation by 1000. And next thing, suppose if the power is not given but V and I is given, because power is equal to VI, then you can use it like this. Instead of power, V into I, and time is already there, 1000 is already there. This is the amount of energy utilized in a by a particular appliance or in a particular house. This answer is actually in kilowatt hour. And then when you multiply this answer in kilowatt hour, that means energy consumed in kilowatt hour into cost of 1 kilowatt hour, that means you can say price of 1 kilowatt hour, then you will get total amount. That means your electricity bill. So likewise, we will calculate the electricity bills. So we are having some numericals regarding this. So I hope you have understood it. That means your power should be in kilowatt hour. If it is not in kilowatt hour, then you have to divide that equation by 1000. And if the power is not given, then you use voltage and current. They will be given. But here what we have to take care is time is in hour. That is the important thing here. That means time which we are using is in hour. Then divided by 1000. Then cost of 1 kilowatt hour will be given. We have to multiply our answer by that particular amount, then we will get the answer. Our last topic is heating effect of electric current. In class 9th, you have learned two things. One is heating effect of electric current and one you have learned magnetic effect of electric current. Magnetic effect of electric current you have used in electromagnetism. Right? And this heating effect of electric current we will use here. We have already discussed in first section that if the current is made to flow through a conductor for some time, after some time the conducting wire or the conductor becomes hot. Because of resistance inside the conductor, some amount of electrical energy will be converted into heat energy. Same thing is here, and that amount of heat produced in that conductor depends on the amount of current flowing through it. That means it is directly proportional to square of current flowing through it. If the current flowing through conductor will be more, then obviously the amount of heat produced will be more. And similarly, directly proportional to resistance and directly proportional to time. for what time you have used it. If you will make the flow of the current for less time, then less amount of heat will be produced. And if you make the amount of current flow, or if you will make the flow of current in the conductor for a longer time, then the amount of heat produced will be more. That means actually this H is directly proportional to I square RT, and when we remove the proportionality symbol, still it remains I square RT, because here the value of constant is 1. But the answer which you will get will be in joule. So if you want to convert it in calorie, you have to convert this joule into calorie. Simple. So that we have already studied in the second chapter. So same thing. Now your answer will be in calories. Basically, it is always in joule, but still if in any numerical it is asked in the form of the calorie, you can use it. So this is the heating effect of electric current. That's all about the C section. We can see some numericals in next video, and rest of the things we will see in next class. Thank you.